just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Hands it to the back. Brink gets about 4 yards on the play. That's a gain of 4. That makes it 7-6. Second down and 6. Ball on their own 39. He's at midfield.
He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff. Just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 46-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. To the 20. He's taken down at the 2-yard line.
This guy is so versatile. You can use him at the line as an extra blocker or send him downfield like another wide receiver. Either way, he's a great resource on every down.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and goal. And he tacks on the extra point. A 5-play, 65-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 7-0. They'll bring him down at the 36. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And they make the stop around the 32-yard line.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. Around the 38-yard line.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. With the pass, incomplete.
You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens?
Awesome. booming kick. He makes it to the 32-yard line. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against his defense.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Church on play action decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He dives, and he'll be marked down. He got the first down and much more.
I'll tell you what, this guy is a threat every single time he touches the ball.
From their own 45-yard line, first down. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. They come out in a five-wide set. Short over the middle. And he is drilled at the 40-yard line. This is the eighth play of the drive.
Kirk, good news. The guy that we saw go to the locker room with that injury earlier is back on the sideline, and I got to bet he's going to be back in the game soon.
What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
From the 25-yard line, it's first down. Runs outside for a nice gain. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Taken down around the 17-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. And they get nice yardage on that run. An exciting first quarter comes to an end. Our score here at the Sun Bowl is the Blue Jays 7, the Phoenix nothing.
Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. This is the 13th play of this drive.
Go down, go down. Mike, throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Good throw, caught, touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 14-play, 67-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So our score, 14-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Nice run there. It's second and six. Ball on the 35. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. They come out on an empty backfield. It out to his receiver in a hurry. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
Brought down at the 35. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's tackled at about the 35. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. He might have a chance. And he's tackled that with positive yardage. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Fight four.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in. That's going to bring up fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Meade is the punter. Taken down at the 26-yard line. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? From their own 31-yard line, it's second down.
Mike Moore.
tackled after a decent run up the gut. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. 2 minutes to go in the half. He tackles him for a loss. Loss of one there for the halfback. The offense calls a timeout. Tackle right around the 48-yard line.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up in man, work that slant route until they stop it.
From the 48-yard line. First down. Gets it. He's in space. Tackle made at the 37. Makes it out to about the 29.
Second and two.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Throws quickly and it's almost intercepted.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
So it's third down and they've got about 2 yards to go. Tackle him there, and he's still going to be short.
That was nose-to-nose football right there, and the defense this time wins the battle. Did you see how calm he looked as he stood back there and read the defense? When you know what you're doing and what should be happening, it makes things a lot easier.
Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And he's level at the 5-yard line. The sub package in there defensively in this 5-wide receiver set. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown.
For the passing game, it was absolutely the right call in that situation.
He makes the PAT. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. Our score here at the Sun Bowl is the Blue Jays 14, the Phoenix 7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Defense has been dominant in this game. Yards very hard to come by. But David, as we get deeper and deeper into this game, the natural assumption is that the pressure goes to the offense to do something.
Yeah.
How much pressure is on the defense not to make that catastrophic mistake?
Well, that's the conundrum you get in. I mean, it makes it exceptionally tough because you want to play perfect and you want to get them to punt every single time, but it's not the way it works. And it's those big plays that you usually see that kill the defenses and break their backs. And you can hold them great, Reese, on first down, second down, it's third and long. You're in a perfect situation. You give up that one play for 80, and it changes the whole complexion of the game. So I think you got to have a little bit of both. It can't just be great defense the whole time. Usually the teams that play great defense can keep you in it, but only for so long. At some point, that offense has to get something going.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. We always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Play fake. Defense bearing down. Quick throw. Almost intercepted. From their own 30-yard line. Second down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's taken down. Right around the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Short pass, middle of the field. And they make the stop at the 26. From the 26-yard line, first down. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. He steps out right around the 18-yard line. The halfback with a carry. He makes it to the 18-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Around the 18-yard line.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
This corner isn't the biggest guy on the field, but he made a nice tackle there.
From the 15-yard line, second down. Puts on a move, touchdown.
Boy, he looked determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him out of the end zone.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point. And now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute, put points up.
I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect.
They'll bring him down at the 33-yard line.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball.
Gets him open field. Makes it to the 44. Forward to about the 46.
That makes it second and eight.
It's second and eight. Ball on the 46. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And he's taken down right around the 38-yard line.
Well, these days, you've got safeties playing up close to the line of scrimmage, almost like a fourth linebacker. The only way that you can keep them from cheating up is to take some chances downfield.
They come out in a five-wide set. He's got it with room to run. And he shoved out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Gets to about the 24-yard line. From the 24-yard line, it's second down. It's complete. He's tackled at the 12. So with one quarter remaining, we're deadlocked right now at 14. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He's in for the touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. Church, ready to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer. And that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. With wide out. Tackle at the 42-yard line.
from their own 42-yard line. It's first down. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
That makes it second and 10.
Six-yard line.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver, but it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out look.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
That'll make it second and 4.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. They'll drop him for a loss.
I love to see this press. These cornerbacks have the toughest job in college football, and that's to cover some of the fastest players on the field and receivers. And for a corner willing to come up, get off of his block, and make a play to disrupt the run, that's as good as it gets if you're a defensive coordinator.
That'll make it third and 13.
To get back in this game in the fourth quarter, this third and long is huge. He rifles it. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him 6.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he hits the PAT. So that's an 8-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. He's got a stalemate right now, 21 apiece. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Some steam on that throw. Locked down at the 37-yard line. From their own 37-yard line. First down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. And he just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion. I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
We've got 3rd and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Quick strike to the receiver. He's taken down around the 47-yard line. Takes it in at the 14. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. 22-yard line. Second down. And he tackles him hard at the 22-yard line. Chucks it downfield. Almost intercepted.
Number 86 was his intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and 12.
Ingram back deep to return. He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
Late here in the fourth quarter now in a tie football game. And it looks like, barring another score, we might be headed to overtime.
Just over a minute left. Throws it, and it's tipped away. From the 48-yard line, it's second down. Five wide. To that quickly, and he is drilled at the 38. Situation here. It's second down and one. A little toss across the middle. And they make the stop. The 26-yard line. Offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up nine on the play. And down he goes, around the 3-yard line.
The defense has got to do a better job at the point of attack. That time they gave up enough of a cushion there to be able to get the offense a first down. They've got to get more aggressive, get lower. They want to get the football back.
And they'll score. Point. If they field this kick, they'll have to bring it all the way back for a touchdown, or this one's over. He sends this one deep, and they can forget about returning this one. Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. For all of you watching, it's been a great game, and it has a chance to be even greater. Will the prayer be answered? It's time for the Hail Mary. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 28-21. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.